We started about some two properties of objects, like it was appearance and then it was its hardness. So today we are going to study about a property called solubility. Like now, what is solubility and insolubility? We will know in some time. Like here it is. Some substances completely disappear or dissolve in water. These substances are said soluble in water, okay? And other substances do not mix with water and do not disappear even after we stir for a long time. Such substances are known as insoluble in water. Now, the main thing which you are supposed to keep in mind is the soluble and insoluble, okay, insoluble words. Like if an object is soluble in water, then it is said that it is approved with solubility property, right? So I have done an activity here. This picture shows the water and mixture of water and salt, and this picture shows the mixture of chalk powder and water. Now you can clearly see that in this picture you cannot see salt. Therefore, salt has dissolved in this. So we can say that salt is soluble in water. Whereas this one, chalk powder, is insoluble in water because it is not mixed properly. Now we are going to come to a term called buoyancy, right? That is the upward force applied by the fluid on the object or the body when an object is put or submerged in the fluid. Such process, such force, the force is known as buoyancy. So now let's experiment and see what does that mean. So here I'm applying force to the mug in the water. It itself comes up with some external from the force inside. So this force is known as buoyancy. Okay, so this is not in your book. This is something really interesting to know. Okay, so let's move forward. Now there is a property known as flotation. Okay, some objects are light and some are really heavy. Now we can categorize these objects in two on the basis of its floating. Okay, whether it floats or whether it sinks. So now some materials which are lighter than water, which floats on water, just like this feather you see on the right-hand side, it floats. Whereas some objects, some substances which are heavier than water just go beneath the water, that they sink in the water. They basically go deep inside and sink there, just like the key on the left-hand side, right? So this determine the flotation property of an object, whether it floats on water or gets sink. Now this is kind of last property, last basic property which we are going to study, which is known as transparency. We can categorize the substances in three groups according to its transparency. Now, what is transparency? Transparency is the ability of transmitting light. Now, the object here you see is an opaque object. Object here, the glass, is translucent. Whereas this glass is transparent. Now let's see what are the difference between all three of the object. An object which does not allow passage to light is called an opaque object. If an object does not let light through pass through it, then the object is known as opaque object. We cannot see through an opaque object like wood, metals, then cupboards, right? Now Second thing, the glass we saw, an object which always allows partial passage of light is called translucent object. Like we can partially see through it, partial light can pass through it. Example, plastic bottle or some paper cups, right? Now, the third category is an object which allows visible light to pass through it is called a transparent object. We can clearly see through a transparent object like a glass or a fish tank, right? These things allows light to pass through them completely. So on the basis of transparency, now you know we can divide the things in three. So that is what for our this video. The part two is now over and we are coming to an end. Yes, thank you everyone, and see you all in the next video, right? Thank you, subscribe, like, share to our channel, and stay tuned for our next video. Ta-da!